Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to discuss another issue of multiprocessing scheduling that is known as load balancing. How to balance the workload between every processor in a system and what are the types to implement that processing system. It is very important to note that the workload should be balanced between every processors distributed evenly between the system. Now, otherwise the other processors would become idle while one processor become overloaded with the least of processes waiting for the CPU. Load balancing evenly distributes all the workload between the processors in a system. It is to note that the load balancing is often necessary in only the system when the processors has their own private ready queue with the processes for execute. Now, if the processors have a common run queue, then load balancing is not that much necessary because if a processor becomes idle, then it can choose and extract any process that is idling from the thread pool and execute that process. Thus, load balancing becomes an overhead in this type of system. But we have to consider also that for some virtual contemporary operating system like Linux, Windows, and Solaris, all our processors having a private ready own queue. So that is why we must implement the load balancing technique. Now, there are two types of load balancing. One is a push migration and another is pull migration. In push migration, there is a specific task which periodically checks the load on each processor. If it finds an imbalance, then it evenly distributes the workload of the processor that is being very busy, pushing the process or moving it from there to an idle or less busy processor. By this way, it distributes the workload among the processor. In contrast, in pull migration, any processor if find that it is idle and there is a non-idle processor having a more processes in the ready queue, then it can pull it from there to exactly and execute from it in the next queue. Now, in this push and pull migration might not be mutually exclusive to each other. It can be implemented and run in parallel. Some systems like Linux and ULE scheduler that support the FreeBSD operating system implements both types of load balancing each other. Interesting, load balancing this counteracts the benefits of processor affinity. The benefits of processor affinity is that a process can be run on the same processor that it is currently running to have the processor data structure only be in the cache memories of the running processor. Thus, the sharing of data need is become very less. But when we are talking about push migration and pull migration, it actually restricting the benefits of that processor affinity. So due to this reason, for particular reason, when a processor becomes idle, it can pull processes from the non-idle system. But the push migration only happens if there are exceeding some certain threshold of the overload work. Then only a processor moves from one process to another process. So as it often in the case of system engineering, there is no hard rule concerning about which policy is best and we have to choose according to the need of the push and pull migration. That is all for load balancing. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.